Yes.
But I want to open with prayer. I think this is a good thing, and I think there are many Filipinos that we'll see in the next few weeks, particularly when their holiday season is over. I know being away from your structure, your roots, your home's church, your family, makes it a little difficult to maintain your spiritual vision. And I want to take a moment and to pray for all of our Filipino workers that are here, that they would not lose their spiritual vision. Living on a yacht can be wonderful. It also can be not very spiritual. But let's take a moment and pray. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we ask you, Lord, that you would touch hearts today. We ask you, Lord, that you would move upon these precious people. Bring them, draw them, keep your hand of protection upon them, not only their lives, Lord, but their heart. Keep your hand upon their heart, Lord, this day. Lead and guide them, Lord, in things that are spiritual, conducive. Bring them closer to the throne of grace, closer to the arms of God, closer to the word of truth. Lord, may they not become distracted in this land. May they not become distracted, Lord, as they are away from home and family. We ask you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, to lead and guide them, Lord. Let the light shine upon their path. Jesus, in your name, praise you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, welcome. This is a good thing. This is a good day the Lord has made.
Amen.
We're happy to be here. We're happy that you're here.
Amen.
Sister Virgie.
Praise God.
Gail.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Everybody say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Lord.
Amen. Praise God. We thank the Lord that this is the first Filipino service. Not only Filipino, together with some nationality from China, Turkey, America. So our service will be Taglish. You know Taglish means? Taglish means Tagalog and English. It's a Filipino language and also with American language, English language. Amen. So we're so thankful that the Lord has given us this day. We know that He has something good to happen to every one of us, especially the Filipino. It's really our heart's desire to get all the Filipino here inside the church.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Because we know the urgency in this world. You know what's happening in our world. The world is full of chaos.
Troubles.
Yes, troubles, problems. But we know that we are the key. We are the key as a Christian to get them back to the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So as we come to the Lord, shall we all stand?
Hallelujah.
Amen. Shall we sing?
Thank you, Jesus. We're going to start with Hallelujah.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Amen. You can sit down again, mga kapatid. Praise God.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Oh,
we're so thankful,
Lord,
mga kapatid, sa ating Panginoon, because He gave us this day to worship Him. Not all the time. All the time, we're too busy in our works. We're too very busy in daily things we do in this world. But this day is the day for the Lord. This day is the day for Him to be thankful. It's the day for Him to give our best to worship our God. Amen. So when we come here, we have a gratefulness in our heart. We have a thankfulness in our heart. So when we sing, let's sing with gladness. Let's sing with our heart. Let's sing with our hands.
Yes.
Let's sing with
yes.
our whole
Hallelujah.
Us in giving God the praise. Praise God. So Amen. Mga kapatid, sa first timer, Sister Emily, she is first time here. And I know
Welcome.
Sister Emily is first time also attending this kind of fellowship. Praise God.
Praise
so
God.
I know the Lord has a purpose why I met you in Ajibadem, Sister Emily. And this is the purpose why God let you come here in Ortakoy. Praise the Lord. So the Bible says to our tree, which are gathered in His name, there He is in our
presence of God.
Praise God. So we are more than two, we are more than three. We are many here. And not only us, mga kapatid. You see our bench here, the chairs are, we can see no people around. But you know who is with us. The angel of God is with us to
Amen.
Worship Him.
Amen.
That's why, mga kapatid, don't be discouraged if we are only new, if we are only few. Let's give God the praise. Let's give God
Amen.
The glory. Let's give God all our strength to worship Him. Amen?
Amen.
So shall
Amen.
We all stand, mga kapatid? Amen. Tayo ulit tayo, mga kapatid. Shall we all stand? And let's sing a song.
You want to do What a Mighty God?
What a Mighty God we serve. Amen.
Amen.
If you have problem, just leave it to the Lord. Amen. Learn learn to smile. Amen. Learn to smile. There is a saying that says one preacher preached this way. He said that there's one man carrying one sack of rice. You know? Then when he goes inside the car, he's still carrying the sack of rice. And they are wondering why she's still carrying the sack of rice. You know why, mga kapatid? Same as when we come here inside the church, sometimes the problems we still carry. Why don't we give it to the Lord?
Amen.
Instead, that man, instead the sack of rice, he can put it down to the car, so he will be not so tired, you know. So is us, mga kapatid. Kung may problem man tayo, kung may mga problema man tayo, ibigay natin sa Panginoon. Huwag natin itong pasanin. Huwag po natin itong kunin na mag-isa.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
Huwag natin na sa Panginoon, mga kapatid, kung may problems tayo. Kasi kung may problems tayo, we cannot praise the Lord. Kasi we magnify the problem rather than God. We must magnify God rather our problems, mga kapatid. Praise God. But once again, we sing again.
How great is our God?
How great is our God?
How great.
How great is our God?
of all our praises,
God,
O God.
God, we praise you, Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. We magnify you, Lord God. Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Oh God, we praise you, Lord. Jesus. Hallelujah.
Oh Jesus, we magnify you.
Ah, God, touch today. Lord, blessings Jesus, of God, goodness and mercies of
we
the Lord.
We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord.
Jesus in your name. Jesus
you,
in
Jesus.
Your name.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Did everybody say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. You may be seated now. Mom, any announcements?
Well, this week we will have Pentecost prayer at 9 o'clock in the morning on Tuesday, okay. If anyone can come.
Tuesday? Mm-hmm. Pentecost meeting on Tuesday, Sheena. Day of home. Praise
and
God.
And then on Thursday evening at 6 o'clock, I know many times people are working, but if you're available, we have prayer also here at 6 o'clock on Thursday.
Or if you can pray at home.
You can pray at home with us, of course, if you cannot come, because the 9 o'clock prayer on Tuesday is especially for the Pentecostal experience to come to us, for us to be yes. ready, for God to pour His Spirit out in this land.
Praise God.
And fasting first Monday, Tuesday.
That's right. First Monday, Tuesday. That is this Monday, Tuesday. Every month, the first Monday and Tuesday, we have special prayer and fasting. Okay. Whatever we can fast and however much you can pray. And this is mainly for our group here. All of our needs, personal needs, family needs, spiritual needs, number one. Of course, and for this church, we pray, and for all of our people connected with this church, these praise 2 days.
Amen. So, mga kapatid, kung may mga time tayo, punta tayo dito ng Tuesday, Thursday. Amen.
Amen.
If you have time, you can go here on Tuesday and Thursday. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This first Sunday of July is also the first Filipino athlete sports fest here in Istanbul. That's why some Filipinos are going there. So I said, it's okay. Oh. We're just starting for the 2 or 3. We know God will multiply us.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Lord, He will. He will.
He will.
Yes,
Amen.
He will. Amen. We'll just start. So, in our hands, we will get them to come here in
Amen.
This church.
Amen.
Praise God. So, is there any testimony or thanksgiving to our God today? Praise God. Is there any testimony? Sister Sheena, you came from Yating.
Yeah.
It's a good.
Thank God I've been there. It was fun and very nice place. For him and also
Marlies.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
It's good to be back in Istanbul.
Praise God, and you're with us.
Yes.
I'm not expecting Sister Sheena to come here.
I never thought also that we are coming today. Yeah. We're coming back today.
He really
is.
That's great.
Yes.
Amen.
Really, God make a way. Praise Amen. The Lord. And Sister Vicky, you have something to thank for?
Well, I'm thankful for this whole trip here and friends who were able to take me around. And, very special gratitude. I've seen a lot. The Lord's shown me a lot, so I'm really thankful for that. Now I can go home and share to my church
Amen.
People and let them know that it's not to fear to come here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
You're always welcome here, Sister Vicky. Praise God. Sister Emily? Amen. So, in behalf of Sister Emily, I'm going to give God the praise that she will that she is with us today.
Yes, amen.
Amen. And anything. Yes.
Oh,
any
thanks.
Testimony? Me first, I would like to thank the Lord for a dream come true. This is a dream come true for me.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. I am here in Istanbul for almost 1 year. Sorry.
Amen. It's okay.
Praise God.
Thank God.
And it's my heart desire to have a fellowship like this. For almost 6 months, I don't have any fellowship. I came here in May and I met you, I think, in October. So how many months I have no fellowship? So I'm just inside the house. And, you know, my heart is grieving because I want to have a fellowship like mm-hmm. this. I want to really express my love
yes,
to God.
Yes.
Not only in the church, not only in the house. It's good to have fellowship also with the brethren like this. Before I was in Libya, I have also fellowship, but it's not like your own family. It's not like the same beliefs. But I have fellowship because I don't want to be stagnant inside the house,
yes.
not knowing the Lord. So when I came here, it's my heart's desire to find a real church, a real children of God to be with. And I thank the Lord I found this.
Amen.
Praise Amen.
God. We're happy.
And one of my heart's desire is to start again the work here. Because, you know, many stories in my life. But it's really my heart desire to be back again in work with the Lord. Amen. So that's the one that
yes.
I'll be grateful.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Keep bring him back.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, Lord. God, we praise
you. Thank you, Jesus. Yes.
Sorry.
God, we praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
So, yun lang, malaki pa sa salamat ko na ipinalik niya muli ako dito sa kanya. Really, I really miss this kind of fellowship, this kind of, the way I stand here, I really miss because I've been working for how many years, for more than 15 years preaching, standing on the pulpit. But how many years, 8 years, I stopped. But I thank the Lord. He
Hallelujah. Amen.
And He bring me
Hallelujah.
Back again to work with Him.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
That's all, mga kapatid. You know, malaking,
malaking
pasasalamat ko sa ating Panginoon.
Yes.
Praise
thank
God.
You. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
God, we praise you, Lord. We praise you. Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Bless your name. Bless your
praise
name.
God. Thank you. That's why some
thank
of my posts in the Facebook, I said, "This is real me. I'm not the one in the world. This is real me, working
thank
in the Lord,
Jesus.
Working with you." In our
God.
Praise
you,
the Lord.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise
Jesus.
God.
Jesus.
So,
hallelujah.
Salamat sa Panginoon. Sister Celine is not here. Sister Candy is not here. Sister Emmeline is not here. Sister Sophie is not here. Sister Sophie is not here. We're still praying, mga kapatid, that God will make a way for us. Amen.
Amen.
I know He will always make
Amen.
A way
yes.
that we can be together. In
Jesus
the Lord.
In
praise
Amen.
The Lord. Hallelujah. So, mga kapatid, shall we all stand again? And shall we sing a song? Do you know the song? Give and it shall come back to you. No. Goodness, sure. Okay. Let's sing a song, ma'am, for giving.
Okay.
Shall we give our tithes and offerings?
Okay. When I think of the goodness of Jesus, do we know that one?
Yes.
Jesus, all He has done for me.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes. Shall we pray for our
thank you, Jesus.
Offerings and together with the prayer requests? Which, do we have any prayer requests, Ma'am Patid? Yes, Sister Sheena.
Please let's pray for my ill mother. She was very
yes.
These days. I'm still praying that God will heal her completely.
Yes.
Actually, she is suffering for 7 years of ovarian cancer.
Yes, let's pray for Sheena's mother. Amen. Another prayer request? Yes, Pastor.
Let's pray for my niece. She's trying to get into high school. And it's tough time with the tests and all that. She's got her results. Now she just needs to find the correct school to start. So okay. Let's pray for God's guidance on that.
Amen. Any prayer questions, Mom?
Let's please pray for my mother also. She's 87, but she needs a touch from the Lord. And my younger sister needs special prayer. She's been having some very difficult times. And she needs some prayer.
Praise God. Any prayer requests? Let's pray also for Ankara because Brenda is keep on calling me and telling when is the church open. I said just hold on and we'll see what God can do for you. And let's pray also the Filipino here, our Filipino brethren here. Let's continue to pray for them that they will come also here. And that also Filipino, sorry Brother Ahmed, I'm always telling Filipino because you know the burden is in me. And of course let's pray also that, of course everyone we need to pray.
Yes.
The Turkish,
yes.
The
yes.
Iranians, the Russians, everybody that's
right.
Here, we
everyone
need to pray everyone.
Jesus.
Amen. So, yes. Hallelujah. So let's pray.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yes, Lord Jesus,
yes.
In your name.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
My Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. O Panginoon, bago pa namin sambitin, O Diyos, ang iyong
Jesus in your name, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
O Diyos, ito yung binigyan na ng katubunan, Panginoon. Ang tabi kailangan na
sa Diyos.
Ayaw ko naman kami ng pananampalataya, Panginoon. At aming panindigan, O Diyos, ang
iyong
pangako sa aming mabuhay, Panginoon. Hallelujah, dalangin namin, Diyos, ito
hallelujah.
Sa bansang Istanbul, Panginoon, ipuin mo, Panginoon,
hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
hallelujah, saan man naroon ang mga tao na nais mong iligtas sa lugar na ito, Panginoon.
Dalangin
mo kami sa kanila, Panginoon. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Jesus in
dalangin
your name,
namin,
Jesus,
Diyos,
Jesus,
ang aming
Jesus,
offering Jesus, na narito ang aming tithes and offerings.
Jesus,
dalangin
Jesus,
namin, O Diyos, na basbasan mo at pagpalain, Panginoon, at palaguin. Gamitin sa ikalagawa ng buhay sa lugar na ito, Panginoon. Ikaw, Diyos, ang patuloy na mag-bless sa iglesia nito, Lord God. We thank you, Lord Jesus, O God, sapagkat ikaw ang Diyos ng kapangyarihan sa lahat. O Lord Jesus, ang lahat ng ito, Panginoon, ay aming po, Panginoon, itinadalangin sa iyong dakila at makapangyarihang pangalang Jesus.
Oh, God,
amen. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We bless you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. So, mga kapatid, it's time for us to listen for the Word of God.
You want to do the song?
Okay, let's sing first before we heard about the word.
Christ is the
answer. Yes, Christ is the
answer.
To
Jesus, your goodness and your mercy, Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
All that is within me, praise your holy name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise your holy name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I be my Lord Jesus.
I do feel the presence of the Lord here right now.
Yes. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Yes. I am amazed.
Thank you so much, God. Hallelujah.
I have been in very, very large services. And I have felt the presence of God.
Hallelujah, yes.
I have been alone.
Amen.
Felt the presence of God.
Amen.
I have been in beautiful, expensive churches, and I felt the presence of God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
I've been in some churches that would make this look very big and nice, and I felt the presence of God. I am amazed how God does care for us.
Yes.
How He watches over us, how He is concerned about us. I want to, I'm not going to take long. Without a translator, it goes pretty quick.
Yes. Amen.
Is everyone's English good?
Yes. Yes.
You okay?
Yes, we're okay.
Sister Vicki, you okay? John 16, verses... beginning in verse 31. I want to tell you that Satan is already defeated.
Yes, amen.
John 16, 31, Jesus said, "Do ye now believe? Behold, the hour come, and is now come, that ye shall be scattered, and every man to his own. Ye shall leave me alone, yet I am not alone, because the Father is with me. These things I have spoken to you, that you might have peace. Because in this world you have tribulation, but be happy, be comforted, because I have overcome the world."
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Now, Satan has his own gospel. He has his own theology. Satan has a way of trying to confuse or change the Word of God.
Yes.
Jesus said, "Heaven and earth will pass away, but the Word of God will continue."
Amen. Right.
Oh. Regardless of how much Satan tries to destroy the works of God will continue. God and His Word is not the problem. The lies of Satan are the problem. Mm-hmm. Satan is the original liar, the original deceiver.
Yes.
And he is, therefore, the Scripture calls him the father of lies. Yes. And all liars. You see, it began in heaven before there was an earth. Lucifer was created in great beauty. He was created with great abilities. He was one of God's greatest creatures, creation. And Lucifer was so powerful and so beautiful that in time he became jealous of God's worship. Mm-hmm. And Lucifer wanted heaven to worship him.
Right.
This has always been the problem. Lucifer is jealous of people who worship God.
Right.
And now we are in a situation where nothing has changed. God wants us to be thankful to Him. And Lucifer wants us to worship him. You see, Lucifer wants to paint a picture of his strength. But really, he has very little strength. If he cannot convince you to believe his lie, he has nothing. And here is a truth. Satan wants you to think that he is at war with God. But this is not true. There was a great war in heaven. The Bible tells us about it. But it did not involve God. There was a war with Lucifer and his followers and the other angels in heaven. And here is the truth. When God appeared, it was over. There was no longer a war. There was no longer a confrontation. When God appeared, he said, Lucifer and all of your followers, you're out.
Amen.
Get out of here. Heaven's not your home anymore.
Right.
And he cast him and his people out.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Satan has no power in the presence of God.
Amen.
Satan has no ability
yes.
in the presence of God.
Amen.
When God appears on the scene, Satan is automatically defeated.
Right. Amen.
Yes,
thank
that's right.
He has no power over God. It's the other way around. God has power over Lucifer.
Yes.
And this is what Jesus is saying to us here in John. He says, look, be happy, be at peace, be safe, be secure in your knowledge. I have overcome the world.
Amen.
What is he saying? He is not saying that the Almighty, who owns everything, overcame the earth, the world. What he's saying is, in my flesh, Emmanuel, God with us, came as a man. In my flesh, I have overcome the world. He didn't do it with godly power. He did it with human power. He did it with the scripture. Jesus was baptized in the River Jordan. Did you visit there recently?
Last year.
Immediately after his baptism, he began a 40-day and 40-night fasting. During this time, he climbed the mountain. This was an unusual area and an unusual mountain. This is the most dry and the least amount of rainfall of any area in the world. I know there are deserts. This mountain is nothing but stone, rocks. There are no weeds. There are no lizards. There's nothing. It's just empty. It's a mountain of nothing. Jesus climbed this mountain in this 40 days and 40 nights while he was fasting. The scripture says he was hungry unto death. He was at the end. His flesh... You know, we talk about the crucifixion, man crucifying the flesh of Jesus, but it looks to me like Jesus had already crucified his flesh. Mm-hmm. He crucified his human will in his 40 days and nights of fasting and climbing this mountain. He was at the point of death, the weakest point that a human could possibly be. And when he got to the top of the mountain in this situation, there was Lucifer, the prince in all of his glory. There was a man about to die, and Lucifer in all of his glory. I think you got the picture. Lucifer in his height of power, in his glory, in his realm, in his situation, the prince of this earth. This man came to this place, Jesus, in his weakened condition. And Lucifer said, you're about to die. Turn these stones into bread. that you might have to eat. And Jesus said, it is written, thou shalt not live by bread alone,
yes,
but by every word that doth proceed out of the mouth of God. And Jesus defeated Satan with the word of Scripture. He didn't call angels. He didn't bind him. He didn't use his godly authority. He just simply, as a man, said, it is written. Satan tempted him again. He said, look out here at all these lands. Look at these kingdoms. Look at all the greatness of this earth. Look at all these things that I have dominion over. He said, if you'll but worship me, I'll give them to you. And again, Jesus simply quoted a scripture. Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou worship.
Amen.
Jesus said, I have overcome the world.
Hallelujah.
Everybody hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
It is that simple. We struggle. Yes, we're going to struggle. We were made to come into this world to struggle. You know, if you give a child candy every day, it'll die. It'll just eat candy until it dies because it doesn't know. God didn't create us. God didn't come just to make our life full of candy.
Right.
He came so that we could have life, and life more eternal life. He came to bring us eternal life. And through this world, we're going to have struggles. I'm not saying we're not going to have struggles, but what I want to tell you is that God is not affected by the powers of Satan. God is not disturbed. God is not confronted. God is not in a battle with Lucifer. God owns him. Lucifer has no ability to do anything outside of the freedom that God gives him. There's a man named Job. He was a good man. God loved him because Job loved God. Job served God. Job, what the scripture says, was a just and an upright man. Satan came to God. God already knew what he wanted. Satan's hanging around here. God says, what do you want? He said, well, I've been out looking around. He said, yeah, did you see my servant Job? Yeah, I saw him. He serves you because you protect him. Let me touch his life. He'll not serve you no more. My point is, Satan had to have permission to touch Job.
Right, permission.
He had to have permission. God and Satan are not in a battle. We are in a battle. We're in a battle to discern right from wrong. We're in a battle to discern light from dark. We are in a battle to obtain eternal life. But do not be deceived. Don't be confused. God and Satan are not in a battle. Satan is defeated when he is in the presence of God.
Amen.
Just being
Amen.
In the presence
Hallelujah.
Of God defeats Satan. This is why we pray. This is why we sing. This is why we worship. This is why we go to church.
Hallelujah.
To defeat
Hallelujah.
Our enemy.
Oh,
he is our enemy. He's not God's enemy.
Yes.
God has no enemy. He's never had an enemy. He's never had a battle. Who's going to fight with God? Again, there was a great war in heaven. The scripture confirms it. But when God came, he says, you're out of here. There was no confrontation. There was no argument. There was no battle. God just said, Lucifer and all your followers, go, leave. There was no option. But to tell you that God has all power. Jesus said, be of good cheer, I've overcome the world. I want to tell you that that means that he came in the form of flesh. Emmanuel, he came to show us a way. Jesus says, I am the door. That's what he came to be. He came to be a door between this earth and eternal life. He came to create a way where there was no way. He came to make a possibility for us to be grafted in.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
He came to make a possibility for us to obtain eternal life. He came to make a possibility. And when Jesus said, I've overcome the world, in Matthew, he says, all power in heaven and earth. Excuse me. That doesn't leave any.
That's right.
How did this happen? Jesus overcame temptation. Jesus overcame hunger. Jesus overcame fear. Jesus overcame death. Jesus overcame hell. He resurrected on the third day. He said, be good, be of good cheer.
Amen.
Because I have done these things. I have made a way. I've made an opening. I have opened the door. You can do it also.
Hallelujah.
You can do it also.
Amen.
Satan gets his hook in us. And we begin to become confused and the light begins to be dim and we lose our way and we begin to call on God for help. We begin to call on friends for help. We begin to look for a way to get out of the bondage that Satan wants to put us in. We begin to look for some answer. I want to tell you, it is written.
It is written.
It is written.
Amen.
It is written. Amen. Death and hell have been conquered. Sin has been conquered. Disease has been conquered. It is written. It is written. We have a heritage. It is not our own inheritance, but we have been made to have an inheritance with Abraham.
Amen.
It is written.
It is written.
It is written. There is enough here to defeat every problem. There's enough here to overcome every darkness. There's enough here for every situation. It is written. Be of good cheer.
Hallelujah.
Be of good cheer. Don't let the fear of the things of this world affect your life.
That's right.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Some of the things happening around the world right now, it seems that America has lost her vision.
Yes.
It seems that freedom has lost its definition. People came to the new land from all over the world looking for freedom. They were looking for freedom from tyranny. They were looking for a little piece of land where they could plant a garden and build a house and have children. They were looking for liberty from corrupt governments and taxation that did not leave them even enough food for their families. They were looking for a hope of a better life, and they weren't looking for much. We seem to have lost our vision. Having plenty seems to have become a problem. I want to tell you that people say, I'm a Christian. I said, well, can you find yourself in the Word of God? Can you find your lifestyle approval in the Word of God? Can you find the things you do in the Word of God? Are you really a follower of Christ? Because if you're a follower of Christ, then you're going to have a lifestyle that shows these things. I believe in loyalty. We're talking about it this morning. I believe in loyalty. I think Filipinos should have pride in the Philippines.
Yes.
Yes. Americans and Turkish and Chinese or whomever, I think there should be some feelings there. But I do not believe in nationalism. My nationality has changed.
Right.
My nationality is Christian. Mm-hmm. My home is a place I've never been, a place I've never seen. I'm on my way to a city called heaven.
Amen.
I'm on my way to a new Jerusalem. I'm on my way to a city that's made by God. And here is the whole thing. Heaven is not mine to gain. Mm-hmm. Heaven is mine to lose. Mm-hmm. Because it is written.
Yes.
It is written. The promises of God are written. The just shall live by faith. He that believeth and is baptized, yes, shall be saved. For there is no other name given among men under heaven whereby we must be saved. It is written. We are more than conquerors through the blood of Jesus Christ. We are more than able through the promises of God. We have the artillery. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're spiritual. And this spiritual warfare, we have ammunition. Pages after page, verse after verse, example after example, promise after promise, situation after situation. We have everything that we need to overcome the problems that this life brings.
Amen. Right.
But never be confused. Because we're having a problem doesn't mean that God is leaving us. It does not mean that God is not able.
Amen.
It does not mean that there's not a resource just because we're having a problem.
Right.
We've got, Rhonda has a friend of mine also. She's saying, why doesn't God like me? Why doesn't God like me? Oh, God does like her. God likes her very much. But I have problems. It's easy to see. She has problems that she has created. It's not the judgment of God.
Right.
It's a situation she's put herself into.
Right.
Don't be confused by the doctrines of Lucifer. Jesus is the light of the world.
Amen. Amen.
By his word we have every promise, every hope,
hallelujah,
everything,
hallelujah,
that we need
you,
to
Jesus,
make it through
thank
this
you, Jesus,
life.
Thank you, Jesus.
You know, when you're young, oh, things are so intense. You're so anxious. You just want to do everything. You want to go every place. And you come to a point that you realize that life is not about going and doing. It's about being prepared to walk on streets of gold.
Amen.
Life is about finding out, making choices. It's about making choices. This world is not mine. I'm on my way to see Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And
hallelujah,
nothing Satan can do can stop me unless I let him.
Right.
He has no power over me unless I believe his lies of darkness. This is why I'm a believer, but I'm more than just a believer. I believe the Word of God. I believe the original Word of God. You know, Satan quotes scriptures, but if you listen carefully, you'll find out he don't quote them right. Mm-hmm. Y'all know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
He quotes scriptures. He's got them out there. People are believing Satan's version. Better know what thus saith the Lord.
It was
our strength and protection. It's available.
Hallelujah.
It's open to us. It's freely given. The blessings of God, eternal salvation, it is in His Word. Well, I said it wasn't going to keep you long. Search the Word.
Yes.
Timothy said, study to show yourself approved, the workman rightly dividing the word of truth. There are Bible translations that are conflict with other Bible translations. You better figure it out, folks. Better figure out what the promises of God really are.
Yes.
Where they're really coming from. Because light and darkness, heaven and hell, salvation and death, they're the only thing in all of life that have any real importance.
Jesus.
Just remember this. God and Lucifer are not in a battle. God has total control over Lucifer at any moment.
Amen.
Lucifer has never challenged God. Be of good cheer.
Amen.
Be of peace. God is more than able. Put yourself in God's hands. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Let's sing a chorus. When we have the Spirit of God inside us, God and I make a majority. That's all it takes. Sometimes we feel like we need more other people, and it's good to have other people to support, encourage, lift us up, encourage each other. But this little chorus says, maybe you know it, I've got power that you can't see. God is living inside of me.
Amen.
I can face any enemy because God and I make a majority. Amen.
Yeah. Praise God.
There is power.
There is power. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.